The Power of Mark. On Monday, the 4th of October, 2021, the whole world experienced a social media downtime. Instagram, WhatsApp, and Facebook were down, and the world stood still for a bit. Over 4 billion people around the world interact with one or more of these platforms. 4 billion humans all under the mercy of one man. The way I see it, the leaders of the future won't be the government. It will be the techpreneurs that can impact the lives of billions of people with just the click of a button. Are there pros and cons to someone having this much power? Yes, of course there are. So let's discuss. One man controlling 4 billion people.
That's interesting.
Oh my God.
That's insane.
Like, we don't know.
So I kept calling my network provider just to find out, is anything wrong? I switched up my phone for like 5 times, you know, and that was really insane.
People were leaking SIM cards. Switch your phone, turn off Wi-Fi. The world literally stood still. Someone drove from one place, it was like 45 minutes to my place because he wanted to connect to Wi-Fi. He thought it was his network. And I was like, it is everywhere.
Wow.
The world stood still for about 6 hours or more.
But in a way, I loved it. I loved it, right? Because it revealed how much, a lot of
power,
things.
Yeah.
It reviewed power. It revealed technology
importance,
dynamics.
Yeah.
The importance of, you know, technology. It reviews how much the value of the solution of
this year, sure.
to what we're talking about, right? Mm-hmm. To not just Nigeria, all over the world.
Yeah.
This is really amazing. But of course, like you said, there are downsides to these things.
To one man owning this much
power. There are downsides to these things.
Oh my goodness.
There are downsides to these things.
Well, to me, I'm not bothered if one man has it, because policy, the government has the right to make policies that would control the excesses of one man holding this thing. My concern is the importance of this thing. This is to tell the government of Nigeria that you can't use policies to stifle youth. Allow our youth to thrive. They should take advantage of technologies to do things to shape their own future and thereby develop Nigeria. So the banning of Twitter is one. Now, if you imagine what happens, that Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp was not working, and then the Twitter was unbanned. So, like, what you know, a lot of us are doing, using these things not just for entertainment. We use this education, business, and what have you. So, it's to teach everyone a lesson that we have to be serious with technology and allow our youth to thrive, because we can have so many Mark Zuckerbergs in Nigeria. It mustn't be. Why can't we develop a Nigerian-owned app that will be used globally, that can have global relevance? So the government has to support the youth.
So yeah, apart from even having like global, developing our own app locally and then having global relevance, you know, in China, they don't use this product. They don't use this platform. They've built their own platform that they use. In India, they started back in 2019. They stopped using all this platform. They have their own platform. Mm. So as we're experiencing it, some people are still using it, but as we're experiencing it, it wasn't as bad in those parts of the world because they have their own platform. As this one was down, they're on to their own platform using. But in Africa, in Nigeria, Kilani, what do we have? We were leaking SIMs, and some people were praying to Mark, like, Mark, don't do this stuff. Please come back. Mark, I was cracking my brain, like, what was I using before this trip platform?
Nothing.
What was I using? I could not remember. Bola, I don't
email,
know if you...
I guess.
Did you experience it? How was the experience
Why
for
not?
You?
I had to run back to LinkedIn because people were just looking for different way out and all that. So, well, this goes to show that technology is important in our day-to-day life. I mean, this is 2021. You cannot be advocating against technology when you are supposed to use it to advance your systems. Even governments rely on technology. Even many governments around the world, they felt the weight. That was on Monday, right? On Monday or so. Monday, they felt the weight. So, I mean, saying that technology is backward is not good. You have to rethink your policies.
Yeah, and you know, Nigerians, did you see the meme about when the world stopped because of social media, that is the end time, or what did they call this? That the angels are about to drop. That's why the world stopped. Oh my God! But that
brings me back to, you know, the previous conversation around entrepreneurship, weaving entrepreneurship into education, right? Mm-hmm. So when you think about when did Mark really start his journey into technology? I mean, when he invited four friends, three friends, you know, into the dormitory, and I mean, some people bailed out, and then we have some people that are now co-owners of Facebook and Instagram and Twitter. That tells you that the 17-year-old, or even from 15-year-old, what are they really learning? And I must give kudos to some very tech platforms that are now beginning to, you know, teach girls to code, teach boys to code, and young people. We need to get our young people quickly embedded into this whole technology, because that's the future, really.
Yeah,
that's the
future.
It's the future.
I'm sure the relevant government institutions are listening. Number one, first things first, the concept of saying a 16-year-old under 18 should not have access to SIM card
is backward. Yeah.
Number two, saying that a girl should not use a smartphone because of religious reasons is backward. And number three, please, can we just allow our young people to fly like birds? That is the only way. See, we the wealth of nation do not rely on beneath this earth surface. It's between the ears of the human. Means that your brain, the technology is the future of the world. It can generate in billions of dollars worth of revenue to the government if they would just allow the youth to thrive. Because if you keep doing the same thing, the same old way, you get the same result you always get. They always talk about oil. They always talk about herding cows from so-so and so place to another place. Whereas some people are thinking of how to solve global problems from Nigeria here. Can we just allow young people to thrive?
Yeah.
Enable them.
Enable environment.
Enable them.
We're not even asking for give us the fish. Create sustainable platforms. And then enable us to actually, we are creators. A Nigerian is a creator. How do I know this? When we move offshore, we really, really thrive.
We thrive.
So I think we just need that enabling environment to create.
4th of October has come, never for it to show up again.
It could show up again.
we are begging Mr. Mark.
I'm not against we using this social media platform. The fact that we encourage Nigerian youth to set up theirs, I'm not saying don't use it.
Yeah,
I'm saying
of course.
Do your own, go global like their own. Let's have fair competition amongst persons that are technically inclined, and we'll go for the best.
Should in case this happens again, if you have an app in Nigeria doing the same thing, you can share with us so that we'll keep communicating. But that's all we have time for today on The Advocate. Join us again next week. The advocacy continues on our social media platforms, on Facebook at PlusTV Africa, hashtag TheAdvocate9NG, and Instagram at PlusTV Africa, hashtag TheAdvocateNG. To catch up with previous broadcasts, go to plustvafrica.com/TheAdvocateNG. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, PlusTV Africa. Join us next week, same time on this station. Let's keep advocating for a better society.